turning up all the way.
Okay.
So you can have... property from the bonuses now. By the National Archives and Birmingham University.
Press the go button that you did.
Without the professor standing by with a fire extinguisher.
Like this picture of September morn. Tell you what you do.
For what?
Put a hatchet in her hand and we'll call it Custer's last stand. Please, someone would like to see you outside.
Who?
Me. And, we'd like you to be the first member.
The first and only...
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Mal Allen.
It was time to head for the archives.
Right. Archives newspaper search.
Archives. time in 1928 that Alfred Lowenstein was
formally informed. Probably at some time you've received an envelope containing anacin tablets from your physician or dentist. Thousands of people have been introduced to anacin this way. Try anacin yourself. Anacin is spelled A-N-A-C-I-N.
We also include a pack of eager reporters.
The press was his first cousin in all this. They set this lavish sort of theater before the people of the airplane landing at the airport.
Screaming nudges again.
Teddy Bridges speaking.
Yeah, this is the Space Information Bureau. What did our 130 bulletin say?
You've been shot up early this morning. One orbit before Milbit must be brought back to Earth.
Oh.
Did you get that?
Right between you. So that, as I see it, is how we've come to be the first people to put a clanger into orbit.
Definitely. You've been on it from the very first thing.
Yes.
The press have been on, of course. Wanted to know what arrangements were made for picking up this astronaut when she gets back.
Oh, my goodness.
Yes,
where? Oh, yes, the North Sea.
Can you be a little more exact?
Yes.
We'll get the whole thing down immediately.
I don't wish to sound disrespectful. Well, it's against all decency and ethics to conceal a mistake. Unless you're quite sure you can get away with it.
Exhibited to All in Wrestling at the Athenaeum for our hourly bulletin on Britain's space program. Agency messages now suggest that the world's first woman in space is not a trained astronaut, but a typical London typist.
Oh, did you hear that, Mark? Oh, I'm glad it's not me.
However, it's now known that the girl who should at this moment be orbiting the planet Mars is a civil service secretary who volunteered for the job. She's a 19-year-old Londoner, and her name is Mildred Murphin.
Oh! Did you ever? It is me.
Babies already. Nobody's smelled a rat yet. But aren't they going to want some details soon?
Details, my dear boy. What they want with details. They're quite happy making up their own. Look at this lady's paper.
Thanks, I'd rather not.
Nonsense. Look at this. Full of good stuff. Listen to this. Tense, pale, but doggedly courageous, Mildred Murphin flies on.
Yes. It is remarkable, isn't it?